to the glory of God. Evangelist, was it easy? No. Did I want to quit? Yes. Did I get mad a few times? Now, I don't know how many people actually saw this. When I was up here one day and I hit so many walls, when I left the platform, I took a book and, I just threw it. Then I had to repent. You're going to get frustrated, evangelist. But you got to learn to walk in love. When they're suggesting under their breath, we don't like you. You make us uncomfortable. Would you please go? You got to say, God, I can't do this. I need something. And he'll help you. He will. Whew. If he didn't, I'd have walked a long time ago. So you're going to get frustrated, but it's going to be worth it. Oh, when you see the look on one of them faces that used to get so upset at you, and now they're saying, let me tell you what happened. I shared my story. So-and-so got saved. It's worth it. It's worth it. It took us 11 months. 5 minutes here, 5 minutes there. 5 minutes, 5 minutes, 5 minutes, 5 minutes, 5 minutes, 5 minutes. 11 months. But faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. There's hope, because we have a book of hope. And the faith comes from the book of hope. But we must preach it from our pulpits. We can't just preach the parts that people want to hear. It's the full gospel. It's not just the part Jim likes. It's not just the part that Carla likes. It's not just the part that Terry likes. It's the full gospel. I remember as a young Christian being in a worship service, and man, it was awesome and anointed. Oh, and we're worshiping God. And the Lord says to me, Jim, the highest form of worship there is when you tell somebody about me. There is no higher form of worship than telling somebody about Jesus. Nothing higher. So after 11 months, we had 68 testimonies. We had them in the racks. And now all of a sudden, I didn't have just Jim's testimony to share, but I had the testimonies of 67 other people. And somebody would come to me and say, oh, I have a cousin that's bound in drugs. Well, I never had a drug problem, but I know 20 people that did. Here's their testimonies. Or somebody comes to me and says, I'm dying, or I'm sick, I got cancer. You know what? I go to these other testimonies because I know somebody that's been there, and I know the one that got them through. So now it wasn't just my testimony, but I had a library of testimonies. Think about the miraculous testimonies that are in your congregations. Think about the lives that God has changed. All we got to do is document them and then sow them for God to use. And those 68 stories turned into our first book. Just the simple real life stories. Here's the neat part. The majority of the faces on this book are now sharing their faith for the first time. There's hope. There's hope. There's hope. The army of God can be mobilized to reach the world for Jesus. You and the members of your congregations are the army of God, and you can be mobilized. So the members started giving the books away. And you know, we serve a God of ideas. He's a creative God. And the next idea was book displays. So I put a challenge forth to the congregation. Every person, take one book display, just one. This is your ministry. And find a business owner and get permission to put that book display in a business. Just one. Wasn't easy for a lot of people. I remember one telling me, you ever see those little animals with the wobbly necks sometimes in the back of cars, kind of bobbing around? 3 months after they bought the book display or picked up the book display, it was sitting back there with the animals with the heads wobbling around. And they would pass the same spot week after week, month after month, and the Holy Ghost be talking to them. Go in there. Go in there. They drive right by. Be driving by again. Go in there. Drive by again. Go in there. Some of them just got tired of fighting. You cannot fight the Holy Ghost. He got your number. And you should have seen the faces of joy on some of the people when they came and said, hey, I got one in the bowling alley. They let me put one in the restaurant. I got permission to put one in the police department. The water company let me put one in their place. And the one that really got me was, I got permission to put one in a liquor store. Right on top of the cigarette machine. Ain't that awesome? And then we had she asked the owner of the bar, can I put this here? Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. We're taking the glory of God into the darkness. Let me tell you why this works. This is a God idea. It's not a gym idea. This is how I found out it was a God idea. After Ray taught me about testimonies, I started teaching this in various places for several years. And as I would teach on how to write testimony in these various churches that we were going to, every place we taught it, somebody would come up to me and say, you know, I had this crazy idea a few years ago that we should do all the stories of the people in this church and we should make it into a book. I heard that on almost every church we went to. If it wasn't a deacon or an elder, the secretary, the pastor's wife, somebody told me they had this thought. It was God. When we're all on the same page, it's God. But they were all walking in the page called disobedience. God wants us to walk in the page of obedience. Hear my voice. They heard. You know the scripture says, my sheep hear my voice and they obey me. They follow me. They do what I tell them to do. But they were walking in disobedience.